first return of China, I said about Sun Yat-sen, his core principles. So in this period, after the Sun Yat-sen's withdrawal, the government just went into the warlords, regional military. So at the same time, May 4th movement also started. Very important is May 4th movement, first 2 months. So this movement was started on May 4th, 1919. Many demonstrators approached the Beijing, capital of China, against the Treaty of Versailles and other causes. So what is the dissatisfaction to the China and Treaty of Versailles? So actually in the World War I, the places, some of the places belongs to China, just occupied by the Japan. So here in the Treaty of Versailles, they just promised that to China, the return back to China. Example, Manchuria is one place, belongs to China, it was occupied by Japan, it has to return according to the just negotiations of World War I, that is Treaty of Versailles. But even the China was one of the ally of the Allied powers of England, but it is not returned to the China. So this is the one dissatisfaction. And another, so many other causes, regional causes in the China. Language or science script. They don't want the lengthy script of language which is not able to understand the common people. They want to change the script and language pattern in China. That is one demand. In social equality, there is no social equality in China, especially for the marriage equality for women in society. There is no right to women choose their own husband. That is the one. Then the subordination of women. Subordination of women means women were treated as they subordinates to men. There is no equal rights to the women equal to the men. So there is one of the causes. There is a cruel practice. That is a cruel practice of foot binding. This is one of the social levy practiced in China, the time of Tang dynasty in China. So we do have in India many social practices or practices just like sati, child marriages, such kind of practice. Foot binding also one of the social levy. They used to bind their foot, they used to tie their foot when they are in early younger age, especially for the girls. They used to just imagine this is one foot, and they used to tie the foot with the cloths and some rags of cloths tightly, not to grow. At the early age of their younger age only, they used to tie. That is the one social etiquette. There is no meaning behind that. Just a blind belief is that they should not grow the foot. Means they are not allowed to grow the foot of the especially younger girls. That is just a blind imagination. Yeah, blind belief. That also one of the foot binding was followed in the social area. Cruel practice. They don't want to be continue this. And economic development. There is no proper economic development in China. And they want many social changes in China. So all these old demands as well as the dissatisfaction of Treaty of Versailles, which is the places already occupied by Japan, not returned to China. So on these all demands, many demonstrators gathered in Beijing just on May 4th of 1919 they started. We know that 1919 is important year in China, that is the Treaty of Versailles was started. So in the same year they started this movement. This we call as the May 4th movement in China, first return of Chinese Republic. Next up, I said that after Sun Yat-sen, government comes to the hands of the warlords. So warlords is controlling, but after Sun Yat-sen, through the Chinese Republican Party, the Chinese Communist Party, next Liu Mingdan came into the force. Liu Mingdan emerged to the Chinese, that is Communist Party. It is also called as Liu Mingdan, the name of the person, Liu Mingdan, party name. So KMT, Liu Mingdan and CCP, Chinese Communist Party, two major parties emerged in the 1911 in China. Next, so this Liu Mingdan also followed the policies of Sun Yat-sen, ideas of Sun Yat-sen which was brought earlier from the Sun Yat-sen. So here he focused on mainly four great needs, especially to the people, that is clothing, food, housing and transportation. So these are primary needs. So he concentrated, this party concentrated to just emerge the main needs of clothing, food, housing and transportation. Next here he don't want to be, because China is under control of warlords and the regional military. So this Liu Mingdan party at KMT tried to just to overcome the issues in the China and also just overthrow the warlords, and this remove the power from the warlords. Next, here under this party only some development started in China. That is some trade and business. Some cities was developed. That is example cities like Shanghai. Many cities are there presently now China. So they started developing earlier time on this KMT. And later Jia Shimini means petty urbanites means the people or the traders who will stay in the urban areas and do the some small trade and business. That is a petty urbanized living. Used to call it in chains like Jia Shimini. Petty urbanized just emerged from this period. And Peking University, the Peking University in China also started the period of 1902 in China. So they started giving importance for education also in China from the Kuomintang party.